Hello guys, welcome to Bits of Tutorials. In this video, I'll be showing you 18 amazing things that you can do using your Windows command prompt. So let's get started. First one, open CMD in any folder directly. If you find it very difficult to navigate through folders using a command prompt, you can do this simple trick. Just open the particular folder in your Windows Explorer, click on the address bar, and type in CMD, then hit enter. This will open the command prompt window in that particular folder. Second, create a secured folder. Well, if you want to create a secured folder that cannot be deleted or even copied or moved to another folder, then here is a simple command to do that. Just open the command prompt window in the folder where you want to create your secured folder, then type in md space aux backslash, then hit enter. This will create a folder named as aux in the current directory. Now you can put your data in this folder, and if you try to copy this folder or move this folder to any other folder, you won't be able to do it. Neither you will be able to delete this folder. And if you want to remove this folder, simply type rd space the directory name that is aux, then backslash, hit enter. This will remove the folder. But before removing this folder, please make sure that the folder is empty. Third, hide any folder. If you want to hide a particular folder, then just navigate to that particular folder, then open CMD there, then type attrib space plus h plus s plus r, then the folder name, hit enter. Now this is going to hide that particular folder. Now if I refresh it, you will see the folder is gone. Now even if I have enabled this option to show the hidden files, I'm not able to see that particular folder. Now if I want to bring that folder back, I'll simply type attrib space minus h minus s minus r, then the folder name. Now this is going to bring back that folder. So this is a very useful command, as you can put your important files or passwords and just hide them from spying eyes. Fourth, shut down your computer using CMD. Now, if you want to shut down your PC using CMD, you can do it simply by typing the command shutdown space hyphen s. This will shut down your computer as soon as you hit enter, and hyphen r to restart and hyphen l to log off your PC. Now if you want to set a countdown to your shutdown command, simply type shutdown then slash s slash t then the number of seconds of countdown. In this case, the PC will shut down after 50 seconds. And if you want to show a particular message just before shutting down your PC, you can just append this thing slash c then space your message. This message will be shown just before your computer shuts down. Fifth, customize your command prompt window. You can change the background color and the font color of your command prompt using the simple command. Now, just before knowing which colors you can set, simply type color space help. This will show the name of all the colors with their respective code. Now, if you want to change the background to white and the font color to red, you can type color space the background color code, that is 7 and 4. This will change the background color to white and font color to red. Simply you can play around by setting different colors and see which one you like it. The default one is 07. Next, you can also change the prompt that is shown here by simply typing prompt, then your name or anything that you want to set, then hit enter. This will show the prompt to whatever you set. Next, if you want to change the title of this window, you can type in title, then my CMD. This will change the title of the command prompt window. Sixth, create a Wi-Fi hotspot. Now, if you want to create a Wi-Fi hotspot using CMD, simply type in netsh wlan set hosted network mode equals to allow SSID equals to your hotspot name, then key equals to the password that you want to set for your hotspot. Now make sure that you enter a password of minimum 8 characters. So here I will enter password and hit enter. So this will create a hotspot network with name ABC and password as password 123. Now if you want to start the hotspot, simply type netsh wlan start hosted network, hit enter. So this will start your hotspot and share your internet connection. Now if you want to stop the hotspot, simply type in netsh wlan stop hosted network. This will stop your hotspot. Seventh, clear your command prompt screen. Well, this is a very common command which most of you must have already used. To clear the screen and log off your command prompt window, simply type cls and hit enter. So this will clear all the line of codes and commands that were present earlier. Eighth, get a list of all installed programs. If you want to get a list of all the installed programs that are currently installed on your system, simply type wmic space product space get space name and hit enter. This will load the list of all the programs that are currently installed on your system. This may take time depending on the number of programs that you have installed. So here is a list of all the installed programs. Ninth, copy CMD output. Now if you want to save the output of your CMD command, there is a simple way to do that. Simply type in your command, then space, the pipe symbol, then type clip, then hit enter. So this is going to save the output of this particular command to the clipboard. And now if I want to save it in a text file, I'll simply open the notepad, then I'll paste the clipboard contents. So this is the output of this particular command. So in this particular case, I've got the list of all the directories and files that are currently present in this particular folder. 10th, CMD shortcuts. You can use the up arrows and down arrow keys to navigate through your previous commands. You can use tab to show the file names or the folder names in your current directory. So tab is used to autocomplete your file or folder names. Then third shortcut is F7. This will give you the list of all the commands that you have used till now. 11th, check if you are running CMD as admin. To check this, simply type net space session. If you get access denied, it means that you are not running the CMD as admin. 12th, check your IP and get other details. To do so, type ipconfig /all, then hit enter. So this will give you details regarding your IP, all the adapters and the network connections that are currently present on your system. 13th, sorted list of all files and folders in the current directory. If you want to get the list of all the files and folders, then you know the command. It is dir. So you can see the list of all files and folders. But if you want a sorted list, simply type dir /b/s/pipe, then sort. So this will give a list of all files and folders in a sorted way. You can also see the path of each files. 14th, open a web page using CMD. To open a web page using CMD, simply type start, then the name of the website, then hit enter. So this will open that particular website in your default browser. 15th, know the IP address of any website. If you want to know the IP address of any particular website, simply type in ping, then the name of the website, then hit enter. So using this command, you can get the IP address of that particular website. 16th, get the list of all the running processes. To do so, simply type task list and hit enter. So this will give a list of all the services that are currently running on your system. If you want a detailed list, simply type task list then /v. So this will give a detailed list of all the services running currently. 17th, open CMD as admin. Well, there are many ways to do this. You can either search command prompt, then right click, then click on run as administrator, or you can press the Windows key and X key and click the command prompt admin one. So this will ask for permission. Click on yes. So now you have opened the administrator version of command prompt. 18th and the last one, set the current time of your system. To do so, open CMD as admin. Then type the command time. It will ask you for a new time. Simply pass in your new time. Then hit enter. So as you can see, as soon as I hit enter, you will see the time changing here. So the time has changed. But this command is not recommended. Thanks for watching this video. If you like the video, then hit the like button below. And if you want more such videos, then click on the subscribe button. Thank you.